Are there any changes to the agenda from the board?
Yes, sir, Mr. Chairman. I'd like to make an agenda if the board would please consider it. I believe it's under business, new business B1, in reference to ZA3623. I move that a decision on ZA3623 be postponed to August 15th so the applicant developer may deliver to the Board of Commissioners the following items: a zoning site plan for the property reflecting a reservoir build out prepared by a professional engineer with all UDC requirements in 8-2.1E, receiving compliance to include the credentials of the professional engineer that prepared the site plan printed on the face of the site plan to include state license information for that engineer, a report prepared and certified by a retained environmental consultant delineating all state waters on the site. That's my motion. I'm sorry? Yeah. Delineating.
They want to.
I did one of yours. Sorry about that.
Sorry. Is that your motion?
That's my motion.
Second.
I have a motion, a second, to move item B under new business to August 15th with the conditions placed on it by Commissioner Levent. Please vote. That motion carries 5-0.
Item A, old business, zoning request, 88 Days Creek, LLC ZA3623, A1 to Red 6. Tom?
Can we just give a moment, let the folks turn out?
Zoning application 3623, 88 Days Creek, LLC. Located in Commission Districts 3 and 5. The request is to rezone 83.68 acres from A1 to Res 6 for 378 attached residential homes with a density of 4.52 units per acre. This property is located on the north side of Dave Street Drive across from Dave's Creek Lane. The Planning Commission recommends approval of this rezoning from A1 to Res 4 at 2.95 units per acre with a maximum of 247 units. The proposed conditions are shown on your screen. And the public hearing was conducted on June 25th, 2013.
Thank you, Tom. It's in District 3 and 5, I guess, as it says, Part 3, Part 5. Before we start, I know, is there any comments from the board or questions? Commissioners?
Just because of all the information that gets put on us, has been put on us throughout this whole the process of this project, and all the emails we get back and forth and some conflicting each other from one week to the next, I really dug deep into this. I've had meetings, I even reached out and some folks gave me some conditions in which they'd like to see added to this, which I believe we put together for them all in a very small amount. And when we do read these off and you see these, if you're missing any, some of them are part of the UDC already and didn't need to be duplicated on here. I know it's not perfect. I know it's not exactly what you wanted, but you're probably in the 95% range or 90% range. Before we do any motions or any suggestions of motions, I would like to touch on a couple of things. As I read the information about the concrete dust and mineral waste toxicities that were created tossing their mind up about the density of the trees, I suggest that the rock quarry read some of the zoning conditions that which their rock quarry was zoned under. One was 2724. And it holds you to very strict rules along with the state regulating you to keep your toxicities and your dust on your own property, or they'll shut you down. It doesn't become another problem. Your stuff gets on their property, they could actually find you as the trespasser with your toxicities and such. To tell a man that he has to put up a barrier to stop what you're creating, I couldn't imagine any court of land backing that up. You got to read your zoning conditions and read your state rules and regs which govern you. denied this based on those premises alone, I'm sure we'd be in court. I don't have a rule. But I can't imagine that they would hold them liable for what your toxicity is leaving your property on theirs, which in the law reads or could be construed as trespassing their property and damaging their property. I also read this and I'm looking for somebody's done tests. Has anybody done the airborne tests? Where were they located on the property when they did the test? Did they do soil tests? Or is this pure speculation based on what this dust can cause? And that's the whole, you know, I haven't seen that full body test from anybody, but that also should be brought up with this state regulating body. Because if it is happening and the crop quarry is doing this, then they need to do something to stop it. That would be my opinion on it anyways. If I was sitting on my property and I was doing all kinds of things and absolutely disrupting my neighbor, they'd call the police, noise or not, or whatever it is. I'm shooting bottle rockets or doing anything that gets a lot of smoke on their property, all those things, there's laws to protect them from me doing that to them. Just saying. I think this kind of got twisted around it a little bit. Who's responsible for whose mess? If there is a mess, I don't believe there is one. I never heard this until the zoning came up. I don't see any full studies that actually show there is. I only see this that says if you remove the forest, it could happen. Nobody's gotten up at a certain level to capture any airborne dust and test it to tell me what the danger might or might not be. They haven't called the state regulatory body to see either. It just seems like a stab in the wind to scare everybody. I will request that this letter that was sent to us be sent to the state and also sent to Bluegrass for further explanation. If there is a problem, it needs to be handled. But if it's just a farce to scare somebody from doing a zoning, that's not right. I don't know what it is. That being said, I hope I covered all the zoning conditions which were asked for. The fence, ma'am, would you mind showing me where your property is on this thing for a fence if you'd really like to see them?
Can I look at it, please? Go on.
Yeah, please. Just please, careful. Okay.
Just creep.
Here's your property line, right?
This is the street of the property lines, right? This is not the property line. This is supposed to be the property line. The property line is totally straight through that stream.
Actually, I can't get a fence there, but they can get a fence. So you're a couple hundred feet over here. How about this right over here? They'll get you in the water.
Oh, they have to put fence here.
Chairman, while we're waiting, and know what the action's going to be by the board, but when there is action, if there is action in respect to petition approval, some reference needs to be made to this site plan.
All right, further, I guess back to my statements, some of the research we did and some of the things we've got done based on my last motion, the last meeting that brought us here today. What is being displayed up is now the plan from the Res 4, which everybody was looking for. It has been produced. There it is. It's got the state water shown in it. I'm going to show you the paperwork about it, everything that I was looking for, I asked for, we got it. It also has a seal on it. If you can see the seal in the bottom right corner, it's round. May I see the first page, please? Let me further note that those the seal at this stage of the game and a final site plan is truly not, is not required. And we've been through this with council and the director of the department. So we've asked these folks to do something over and above. It's in our UDC. It says, etc. And their terminology of that was because the reason why it's not required at this stage in a sketch plan is simply that there's so many condition changes between this point and what they would bring us to this point, that always those plans have to be changed, and not to put a financial burden on whether it's a developer or just a small mom and pop trying to come forward and get something little something done in their land, doesn't put a huge financial burden on them to do anything more than a sketch plan at first until all the conditions are resolved. Then they get the final plan done for engineering and such to approve. I want to be clear that they did not have to have a seal on there at this point in the game, or a perfect plan at this point in the game. Number one, you're going to see something from our Department of Engineering from April 29th, 2013. They gave them the thumbs up on the state waters in which they did their sketch plan. Number two, please. This was requested by the public, and I put in my motion for the public. If you'll slide up a little bit, they can see the certification of the company that did it. This is their water, a certified company, which they'll ask for, and which they redid their plan with, which matches the county paperwork. We have another one. All right, that's it. And so that covers my motion that y'all asked me to do for reset purposes. It covers it all. Thank you, Jim. Is there anything else anybody else had that they, I may have missed through all of this, going through this? I think we've covered all of it. There's so many emails, so forgive me if I forgot anything that y'all asked for. They bounce back and forth. Some people say one thing, that a week later getting them saying the opposite thing. It got really confusing there for a while. I hope I covered everything. I hope that this piece of paper, they have all the conditions, covers everything you're looking for. If it's missing three or four, once again, they're in the UDC law already, and we don't redundantly replace them here. If you don't mind, yeah, I would like to put that up one more time, please. This has never been done to this extent of me going through things, so if it seems odd, it is a little bit. I'm trying to satisfy everybody. Zoom in just a little bit. And bring it up a little bit. There you go. All right, so you can see the property in the bottom center part of the page, rock quarry just above it. You've got a Res 4 just barely on the other side of rock quarry. Just above that, and it's not focusing perfect, but you have a Res 6. We have folks here that are also from Windermere, as much as from anywhere else, worried about the density. Inside Windermere is a putt. True enough, it is an absolute putt. But inside that putt are multiple Res 4s, with a higher density than the 2.95 that was recommended by the Planning Commission. It also has several apartments as a Res 6. I, for one, like to look at everything fair and equally across the board. If you're going to come from a neighborhood and say everything around is 1.7, it's only a fairly country neighborhood too, concerning you. If you're there, it must be a wide enough range to include your neighborhood too in that calculations. Thank you, Jim. If I may have the proposed zoning conditions back up, please. Just so you may be able to read a moment of time, just scroll slowly for everybody.
Scroll back to 22. Hardy plank mentioned not shall be used over 25%. You can say the rest of the house shall be used hardy plank. No, but it said, okay. But it said main side shall be stone or hardy plank. We use it on the side here. Just want to make sure.
Chairman, I'm having a little bit of difficulty.
22, Councilman.
Well, we just want to make sure it's worded correctly.
Everybody hear me? We just want to make sure it's worded correctly so nobody, this is very transparent and nobody gets something they didn't expect.
Okay, fine.
motion, I move that we accept my motion for the ZA3623, accepting the plan that was shown up as our new Res 4 with the new seal, with no more than the 2.95 homes per acre as shown in number one, accepting all conditions that were shown as they were shown, with additionally adding a fence, which is now just put on the screen between the two arrows. And please apologize if I put your name wrong. Under the, I can't read the door, thank you.
Gabriel?
No, it's Doris and Mark.
Fine Silver,
thank you. On the parcel 154020, we'll add a fence between the two arrows, 6-foot fence, privacy fence.
What size?
6-foot, privacy. And that's my motion.
We have a motion, do we have a second?
Second.
Got a motion, second, any discussion? Please vote. Motion carries 3-2. For approval.
Mr. Chairman, there were two documents in addition to the site plan, which I believe the commission will then got its measure. There was a state water report, and then there was a color zoning map. You just direct that those be placed in the zoning file for the city. I don't need action, Mr. Director.
So then, please do it, Councilman.